So just like the sky doesn't need to do anything about the weather systems and the planes and the birds and the different stuff that's going on inside it, similarly our mind doesn't need to do anything about everything that's happening inside it. So our mind is very similar to the sky in that way. And it's very reassuring and relieving to come to see this in our direct experience. So when an aeroplane flies through the sky, firstly, it leaves no blemish, it leaves no mark. It might have a trail of smoke or whatever it is, but that evaporates as well. And the sky before the plane was there, while the plane was there, and after the plane has left, is always essentially the same in its nature. It remains open, it remains stable, it remains completely at peace. And if you look again at that, you'll also see that in fact the only thing there was through that whole process was the sky. The aeroplane is made out of sky, the sky that pervades everything, the sky that's upwards, downwards, left, right, forwards and backwards. Everything is made of sky. Therefore, the sky doesn't need to do anything about what's appearing within it, because there is only sky-like open intelligence. And so that's the same as us in relation to our data, our thoughts and emotions and experiences and sensations. There is only mind. Expansive, vast, all-pervading mind. And it's always been like that from the day we were born. And is like that right now. So this ability to know, this alert intelligence, alert cognizance that allows for us to experience everything we're experiencing now, the sensation of the seat on our bum, which maybe we weren't particularly aware of until I mentioned it, or the particular thoughts and emotions we're having, the sound of my voice, the sound of creaking chairs, everything that we're seeing visually, all of that happens purely because we have this cognizant mind. It's always the nature of everything that's happening. And at any moment we check, we can check again now and find that that cognizant alertness is still the essence of everything we're experiencing. It's the reason why we can experience anything. It pervades all experience. It allows for all experience. And then when we check again now, it's still here. So you see, just like the sky, regardless of what happens within it, its nature remains the same. It remains open. It remains lucid. It remains brilliant. And it remains stable. And it's not abstract, it's directly the reality of what we experience in every moment. It's not abstract, it's the reality of what we're experiencing. So to know this is just the biggest blessing. And in balanced view, the whole support system is entirely geared towards offering all of the support needed that needed to gain ever-increasing assurance in the nature of open intelligence, the nature of mind. And that relief and that sense of deep relationship with everything grows ever deeper, ever deeper, ever deeper. All it requires is that we aspire to have it grow ever deeper, and secondly, that we have support, quality support, for it to become so. If these two things are in place, then our assurance naturally grows stronger and stronger, without us having to make any effort, without us having to struggle, without us having to compete with ourselves or with anybody else, without us having to put pressure on ourselves in any way. All we do is recognize for short moments the nature of mind and completely rest deeply as that.